Hello, dear learners. Welcome to today's program. I'm Dr. Pallavi Gogoi of Krishnakanta Handik State Open University. Today, I shall be taking up Unit 13, The Romantic Age, Major Literary Forms. This is the second video of this particular unit of the program MA English, Semester 1, Course English Social and Cultural History, Block 4, that is titled Literature, Romantic to Modern. Coming to the table of contents, before I begin this presentation, I shall let you know about the table of contents. It contains learning objectives followed by a brief introduction, then major literary forms, where we'll discuss the significant literary forms of this particular age, and then questions to check your progress and the references. Learning objectives. After going through this unit, the learner will be able to identify the major literary forms that flourished during the Romantic Age. To introduce you to this particular topic, during the Romantic period, they emerged three major literary forms, which were poetry, novel, and literary criticism. The Romantic Age is also known as the Age of Poetry, owing to the great surge in poetic creativity of the major literary figures of the age. Again, when we are talking about the Romantic Age, both the forms of Romantic and the Gothic novel had gained predominance. The Romantic Age had also witnessed a flourish of critical literature in the form of literary and critical essays, which appeared in the contemporary magazine such as the Edinburgh Review, the Quarterly Review, Blackwood's Magazine, and the Spectator. These magazines exerted a considerable influence on contemporary lives. Let us find out more about these literary forms that flourished in the Romantic Age. Major literary forms, starting with poetry. When we talk about the form of poetry which flourished in the Romantic Age, we find that they include lyric, ode, ballad, and sonnet, which were the most predominantly popular forms during this period. Lyric poetry refers to short poems with intensely magical expressions. It is in fact the product of a swift, momentary, and passionate impulse. For example, Wordsworth's Lucy poems reveal the poet's consistent innovation with regard to this form, where he attempts to blend the impersonality of the ballad with an intimacy that approximate confessional voice of the poetic persona. Again, Shelley's Adonis is another lyric which is remarkable for its artistic power. The lyric of Wordsworth, Keats, Shelley, and Byron are remarkable for their personal element. Some of the fine odes were written during the period, instances of which are Wordsworth's Ode to Duty and Coleridge's Dejection and Ode, and Shelley's Ode to the West Wind. It is in the hands of Keats that the ode reached its highest degree of perfection through his immortal creations such as To Autumn, Ode on a Grecian Urn, and Ode to a Nightingale. I'm sure you must have heard of these poems. The odes composed by the Romantics are remarkable for their harmonious flow of music expressed through the exquisite imagination and lofty idealism. The ballad was revived in the Romantic period through the publication of Keats's La Bella, Dame Sense Mercy, and Coleridge's Christabel, and the famous The Rime of the Ancient Mariner. The charm of the ballad is enhanced by its haunting melody coupled with the use of dialogue, which infuses a dramatic quality in it. This is what makes it more beautiful. The sonnet is a short lyric of 14 lines which during the Romantic period flourished in the hands of Wordsworth and Keats, who introduced nature as one of the most prominent themes in their sonnets. Now coming to the next form, novels. The Gothic novel, a popular form during the Romantic period, implied a long narrative that displayed the typical Gothic elements of doom with special emphasis on mystery and magic. Besides this, the regional novel was also another form that came to be widely practiced during the period. As the name suggests, the regional novel represented a narrative that was specifically confined to its creator's regional milieu. Notable examples of this genre are Hardy's Wessex novels and William Faulkner's novels set in this imagined place, which is called Yoknapatawpha country. Next, we come to literary criticism, which was prominent in this age. The literary magazines of this age also performed a very significant function in that they became the voice of the unknown writers. This gave them a scope to publish their works, thereby producing essays of repute like Hazlitt, Lamb and Leigh Hunt. Okay? The publication of Wordsworth's preface to the second edition of the Lyrical Ballads of 1800 and Coleridge's Biography of Literary of 1817, you must remember the years, added more impetus to the idea of literary criticism. Wordsworth, in the famous preface, discusses the nature and purpose of his romantic poetry and the kind of poetic diction to be used for such poetry. Coleridge, in his work, mainly discusses the process of human creativity. Coleridge was inspired from the idea of the German philosophers like Kant, Schelling, and Schlegel. He provided the famous definition of imagination as, quote-unquote, the creative intelligence, to explore the relationship between subjectivity and objectivity, self and the world, speculative reason and rational understanding. John Keats, on the other hand, introduced the term negative capability in a letter written to a friend in December 1817 to define a literary quality. As M.H. Abrams states, Keats's negative capability first characterizes an impersonal and objective author who maintains aesthetic distance as opposed to a subjective author, personally involved with the characters and actions represented in a work of literature. So this is a distancing that Keats talks about. So with this, we come to the end of the discussion. I shall leave you with a few questions to check your progress, starting with question number one. What are the three major literary forms to have emerged during the Romantic Age? Question number two. What is lyric poetry? Mention the names of any two poets who wrote lyric poetry during the Romantic Age. Question number three. Give example of any three ode composed by John Keats. Question number four. Which form of novelistic genre was popularly written during the Romantic Age? Question number five. What does Wordsworth and Coleridge basically discuss in their seminal works titled Preface to Lyrical Ballads and Biographia Literaria respectively? Now we come to the references. I hope you will refer to the MA English SLM of our university. I wish you all the best. Thank you, dear learners.